little do they know I'm smuggling.
Before we do anything, we've got to do a bed check. Oh, Jesus! Nearly winded myself, but it's quite comfy. Flight was very good. I'm absolutely shattered now though, because I had to get up at like 4:15. Not good. Every single person on that flight was either in a couple or 90 years old. So I stuck out like a sore thumb. But I'm here now, so it doesn't matter. So the plan for this trip is to go out into the streets of Rome, do all sorts of exploring, to find myself a beautiful Italian girl, and we mutually fall in love, and she can cook really good pasta, and all her family can cook really good pasta, and then I bring my family over, and then we all just live here and eat loads of pasta and have a grand old time forever. Should we do a room tour?
I think so. So, you come in through the door and you are immediately greeted with this room fit for a king. Apart from that lampshade, that has really pissed me off. Nice table there, a nice big mirror. We can't even fit it in the bloody frame. That is lovely. A nice lamp. A nice light. The bed, which I've already showed you, which is absolutely huge, by the way. I'm gonna space out on the bed and we'll see. 2 seconds.
In all fairness, I'm not a very big person, but it's bigger than me lengthways. I could so easily just...
So the view from the bed, you have my delicious feet and a nice telly, which I definitely won't be using because I brought my laptop.
This is the view. Very, very big curtains. These are like huge. So I've got one of those, like, you know those Italian windows where like you open them and it's like wood, I'll show you. You'll know what I mean. Hey! I mean, the view's not the best, but I like the window, so I just don't care.
Have you got another mirror? Sorry. Me being a freak.
Wardrobes.
And then in here, we have the pride and joy. The bog. Right, the most important thing we have is a bidet or a bidet. But this shit is pretty nice. Yeah, they're pretty cool. They basically wash your bum after you've had a poo. Or just in general, if you've got a smelly bum. But I don't, by the way. I just like the contraption. Fuck, that made it sound like I've got a smelly bum. I promise I don't.
That was my foot. I swear to God, that was my foot. Look.
So I'm gonna get changed and then I'm gonna head out into the streets of Rome. Like, that's pretty crazy to say. Like, I'm just in Italy by myself. Weird. Very weird. But very cool also.
Today has been brilliant, and I've learned a lot of things already. One, I must look Italian. Basically, I walked into a restaurant because I was starving, and the waiter came over and he started speaking Italian to me. And I went, whoa, English. And he went, what? And I went, English. And he went, my friend, is that,
I'm not going to do the accent. My friend, you look Italian. And I went, oh, I'm not. All the staff were just talking at the bar, and I just felt like they were judging me because I was just sat by myself and I could only speak English. And honestly, fair play to them, because I would bully me as well. I know two words in bloody Italians, grazie and ciao, and I can't even say them right. If they were even taking the piss out of me, I don't think they were, but it looked like they were, because they were having a lot of laughs. It is what it is. Can't blame them. The second thing I've learned is that the traffic lights don't work here. When it says green for the cars on one side, it also says green for go for the humans. As you can imagine, humans walking over roads plus cars coming from that direction doesn't really end well, so I've just been guessing when to go. I've just been running over the road. I've been beeped at least 50 times. I'm in their world, you know. I can't be coming here judging them, because this is how they've done it for thousands of years. Who am I to come in and say, well guys, like, what are you doing here? So fuck me, am I right? I'm just coming here judging everyone. Fuck me, not my fault. I bought some snacks from the dude outside. There's some, like, it's like a corner shop, but on the street. Oh, honestly, it's class. I mean, it was £10 for a bottle of Coke, some milk, chocolates, and some crisps, which is a bit mad, but can't complain. He's gonna be my boss man for this trip. So tomorrow is Colosseum. Very, very excited. Actually, it's like, that's like the main thing I wanted to see. I can't even like imagine seeing it. It's like, is it a wonder of the world? I think it is. I can't even imagine like just walking up to it and being like, wow, that is the Colosseum. But I guess we'll find out tomorrow. Some skip. Sorry, I went for breakfast and everything. I've been changed. I just forgot to record because I was absolutely blown away by the breakfast. The view, oh my god, it's on like the roof. Like the restaurant's on the roof. I'm good, I didn't record. I'll record tomorrow. I promise you will see it tomorrow. You have my word. Anyway, you can literally just see the whole of Rome from the roof. I'm pretty nervous to go to the Colosseum though. Like it's a literal wonder of the world. What if I turn up to the Colosseum and I'm just like, oh, it's a literal wonder of the world. What if I'm like let down by it? I don't think it will be. I don't know. I'm gonna try my best to record while I'm out today as well, because I feel a lot more comfortable talking to the camera out here, because like no one speaks English. Well, they do. It's just a lot of Americans and a lot of like Italians, as you would probably expect. Nah, I don't care what they think of me. They could think I'm absolutely like deluded. They could think I'm a schizophrenic. I don't care. They probably do, to be fair. I'm just sort of talking to myself, if you think about it. I've just been stared down by some of the locals and they looked hard as fuck. If someone was recording in my city on their phone like this, I'd think, what a prick. So honestly, fair enough. I'm heavily considering just hiring one of those Vespas and just whipping around everywhere in Rome. And, I don't think that's a good idea. I can barely drive as it is, never mind a fucking Vespa in a foreign country. Well, boys, we've made it. I don't even know what to say to that. I mean, it's pretty nice. I mean, I can see by the corner of the Colosseum, put it that way. It's nearly as big as my head. I'm not funny. Ever since I've arrived, the plebs theme tune's just been going round in my head over and over again. And all I can think of while seeing that in the background is the episode of Plebs when Grumio fingers a lion. But
I must say, while they were in a gladiator match, so that makes sense. When we go, do as the Romans do. I just look like a floating head. Anyway, so I'm on ground level. I'm going to a place called Constantine Hill, or Constantine Arch, to collect my ticket so I can go inside the bugger. I'm going to cause a few fights, a few scraps, just so I can get the real experience of like fighting in the Colosseums, you know what I mean? Nah, I'm too scared. I feel like this vlog's just going to be the weirdest thing ever. It's just going to be me like jumping in between the most random things. I would definitely say Italy's the best place I've been so far. It's just like, it doesn't feel real. It kind of feels like a planet from Star Wars. Everything's just so nice and it smells really nice. The people are nice, but they're very persistent. I'll give them that. And I suppose that's a positive at the end of the day. Yeah, persistence is a good thing. Maybe not aggressive persistence, but... Right, I've been here for 45 minutes looking for a man with a black flag. And I just can't find my boy. My boy! I can't find him. I don't know where he is. If I don't find him, I can't go into the bastard place. Any water. The traffic's really loud, so I'm gonna have to shout. That was an incredible experience. You know, just the ambience, everything about it was just sick. I'd give it a 9 out of 10 because it was incredible. But I just couldn't help but think for that extra point, they should have a live action, like interactive gladiator fight where you get a fight someone, so you get like the full experience. And that's me genuinely being serious. I would have loved to fight someone in there. So that's why it's getting a 9 out of 10. Also, I think now that it's like sort of, they don't use it anymore apart from tourism. I think we should just put a 9 side pitch in the middle because, like, imagine how good that crowd would be. Honestly, the next football stadium, I don't think it'd be too bad. No one would complain. The away fans would love it. I'm just babbling on. I'm going to get some food. I'm going to try and find a place that sort of overlooks it. Because, why not? I'm going to come here once, honestly. I'm now walking over to the Circus Maximus. One, because it's like where the chariot racing was and it's just pretty cool and I really like history. And two, because it's the name of a Travis Scott song and I just want to see what that's all about. All I'm saying is I bet many people don't have their name inscribed on the old Colosseum. I bet they don't.
Actually, right now I'm quite late. I'm gonna show you my outfit and then I've actually got to go. I'm quite late.
I hope you can see this all right. So I've got my white jeans, which I had on today, and my jumper with the matching shoes. Oof, clean. The only problem is I've only got my green watch. Don't shoot me.
this thing gives me a double chin. I'm literally so wet through it. I don't know what to do. I don't know what to, what the fuck.
I was gonna go downstairs for a coffee, but I just can't be bothered. Also, excuse the display of the feet. I can't be bothered to put my socks on. I got absolutely soaked because there was just torrential rainfall on the way down. It wasn't on the weather apps, wasn't on anything. It was actually very nice. I got a mixed grill. I'm gonna have one of these. I bought these yesterday, I didn't even have any. Wow. Milk and chocolate rivals Cadbury's in my eyes. That's a 9 out of 10 right there. My food, I'd say it was an 8 out of 10. Sorry, I've got crumbs all on my bed. I don't know how long this video is going to be so far. But if it's a long, long time, I'm going to split this up into two separate sections. Because I don't want one video being like half an hour or like 40 minutes, because who wants to watch that? Well, probably a few people. Actually, probably not many people, to be fair. So if you're seeing this right now, it means I've split it up into two sections. So this is the first section, so bloody go and watch the next one when it comes out. You better. If you're seeing this now, this is part one. I hope you enjoyed. I'm enjoying myself out here, so I hope you're enjoying watching it. I don't know, should I say something in Italian? Ciao. Ciao. Means hello and goodbye, doesn't it? Or just goodbye. Fuck, I don't know. Ciao.